everyone. Thank you so much for tuning in on a lovely Saturday evening here. I really, really appreciate it. I want to also thank especially Muse West Concert Series for having me on tonight. And I'm really, really excited to be here. So tonight's program is going to be a little theme on the relationship between music and protest. And I called this little recital Odyssey of Dissent. And to me, classical music, music in general actually, really has historically been a wonderful platform for artists and musicians to express various ranges of emotions and even issues that that are near and dear to them. So with tonight's concert, the theme is about protest. And even times, composers oftentimes celebrate their racial and cultural identities through the music. And the last piece that you just heard, I can't think of a better example than that. The piece that you just heard was Fantasy Negra, number 4 in B minor by Florence Price. And for those of you that are not familiar with that name, Florence Price was one of the most important African-American female composers of the 20th century. She was born in Arkansas and in the early part of the 20th century, and she had to deal with a lot of racism and sexism throughout her life. And it's amazing, actually, if you consider the kind of circumstances that she was living in. It's amazing that she was able to be as productive and accomplish as much as she did. I just want to share with you something really, really quickly. And if you want to know more about her life story, I've blogged about her on my website, www.frankhuangpiano.com. But anyways, she has been credited as the first African-American female composer to have a major symphonic work being performed by an orchestra. And that orchestra was the Chicago Symphony Orchestra. So it's just really amazing to kind of read and actually quite inspirational to see what she was able to accomplish. In the piece that you just heard, the Fantasy Negra, she evokes the sounds of African spirituals throughout the piece. Hopefully you heard or got a glimpse of that. But what I think is unique is that she was able to combine and juxtapose elements of the 19th century romanticism and European tradition. And every time I hear this piece and I'm playing it, I can't help but to think of the influences of Frederic Chopin and even Robert Schumann in some of the passages here. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed it. Now I would like to play for you a piece by Beethoven called Variations and Fugue in E flat major, Opus 35, or AKA Eroica Variations. And this piece is a really unique piece in the respect that Beethoven takes the tune from this piece. He loved the tune so much that he borrowed it and used it in two other pieces. And one of those pieces is a very famous work, and it's the Symphony in E flat major, number 3, also nicknamed Eroica. And hopefully you know this work, but if you don't, this piece, there's a very, very famous story behind this. And it was originally dedicated to Napoleon. And Beethoven, he really admired Napoleon, and so he thought. And because he admired him because of his, what he thought was to be democratic ideals and anti-monarch ideology. But when Napoleon invaded and occupied Austria, Beethoven went into a big rage, and he scribbled off the dedication and threw it on the ground and stomped all over it and was really angry, and he changed the dedication. So and many composers and artists at that time, and think about around 19th century Europe, days leading up to the French Revolution, where many were calling for democracy and how all people should be treated equal, regardless of what status you are. If you were someone's master or you were someone's servant, people thought, you know, people should be treated with the same decency as everyone else. So this piece, I think, has a lot of historical importance and just context, considering what was going on around the time in Europe. In this piano piece I'm about to play for you, you will hear the tune throughout, but it's preceded by an introduction that is based essentially on four notes, and it goes like this. And it seems really simple, and it is, and it's amazing, really, when you hear this. It's about a 20-25 minute work. You'll hear what Beethoven will do, you'll hear it. It's very obvious, and sometimes it's not so obvious. It's embedded with a lot of different types of variations, and almost seemingly improvisations, actually. So if you can't hear it, it's okay. This piece is a real finger buster for the pianist. It's incredibly virtuosic, and I love this piece. So I hope you enjoy it as much as I do. This is Beethoven Eroica Variations. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
it for tonight. Hope you enjoyed it. Was really happy and really appreciate that, that all of you could be here. Thank you and stay safe. Good night.